It's the final countdown.
Now, a disclaimer, nothing too controversial this week. Not many stings in the tail of the final five because we are celebrating, yes, celebrating the AFL's wonderful Indigenous round. Matthew, Lloyd, you can kick off. You played with some wonderful Indigenous players. Do you have any regrets about your time with the great Gavin Wanganeen?
Yeah, my biggest regret is that I only got to play with him for 2 years, Caro. So that was seasons 95 and 96. I got to play with Gavin Wanganeen. I was devastated when he left and said, I want to go and captain Port Adelaide. We understood his decision, but to train with him and see his speed, his agility, his bounce, his recovery, wasn't the hardest trainer, Gav, but come game day, he was just phenomenal. Some of these highlights. He was a great player for Essendon, Brownlow medalist, and I just wish, if Port Adelaide selfishly didn't come into the competition, I sometimes say, imagine I got to play with Gavin Wanganeen for 10 to 12 years, and even the way he performed, kicking four goals in that grand final for Port, he was a great player for so long, and I only got him for 2 years, which I would have loved more.
And you know you're great when you have a stand named after you. Leon Davis, terribly sad that he didn't get to play in the 2010 replay. Was it the right decision? And tell us why you love Leon.
I mean, the decision was the decision, but Leon was part of the grand final. Don't worry about that. His goal kept us in the game. But have a look at this. I think Leon is underestimated by people who are not of the black and white persuasion. Look at this for a goal. Leon Davis kicked that many goals that were unbelievable. I remember when he walked into the club the first time, I thought he was the mascot. Noel Judkins showed me tapes of him playing over in Western Australia. This is one of the greatest goals of all time, this. What's this? Bang. Look at that.
And it was goal of the year, wasn't it?
It was, yeah. I think he got a couple. But he was just... This is the goal I was talking about in the grand final. This kept us in it where nerves were absolutely fraying. So Leon deserves the medal and as a Collingwood Premiership player, as far as I'm concerned. But as a bloke, he's a ripper. Ring me this week. He said, do you reckon I could get a couple of the Indigenous jumpers for this week for my kids? He loves the club. He's just a person we turn to a lot. We love Leon Davis.
That's wonderful. And you were a senior assistant coach at the Sydney Swans in 2006, one of Adam Goodes' great years. Tell us about what it was like coaching and working with Adam Goodes.
The most explosive player that I've ever seen live. Just his ability to just break away and then overlap and break the lines from half-back to half-forward. An enduring memory, 06, grand final, three-quarter time. I was the midfield coach. We need a goal. Walk back up to the stands, I sit down and the crowd's roaring. I see the replay. Adam Goodes has sharked it out of the middle, ran forward and kicked the goal all the way, I think it was. So his ability to play with pain was unquestioned. Torn PCL, had a cortisone put into the joint, didn't miss a week. And then the humility. He used to carry the bags off from training, help the trainers, carry the water off. He was a real role model, Adam. Unbelievable. And obviously, Bootgate, you know, his ability to work his way through that eventually. And, you know, our heart went out. We reached out for him, but he's left a big footprint in the sand in AFL football and the wider community.
And Ed, when you and I were growing up in the 60s and 70s, there weren't that many Indigenous players going around, but Sid Jackson
was
one that sticks in both. Talk us through Sid Jackson.
Well, to me, you know, he was a Carlton player, so, you know, he was starting from behind with me, but I always just remember the big number five on his back, and he was so balanced. The way that's a classic example up there, one-hander. But he came, Lionel Rose was my hero as a boxer coming through in those days. And then you had Sid. Unfortunately, this is the 1970 grand final just a moment ago. But just the way he marked the ball, the treatment he copped. But look at that. Out on the wing, they'd kick it out to Sid Jackson. And he'd just take mark after mark, kick goals, his polish and his balance. And then later in life, you get to meet him and what a gentleman. Then you find out his story and what he went through as a kid coming through the stolen generation and the missions and all that sort of stuff. And he still just was an absolute gentleman. He's one of the greatest football icons in the game.
Yep, agree with that. And Matthew, I want to ask you about Michael Long. You've often said to me that you owe him a great debt. Can you explain a bit about what Michael Long means to you?
I grew up idolising the Cracker Brothers. They were two of my heroes growing up watching footy just because of the deft touches and what they did for each other. And then I get to play an AFL career with a guy by the name of Michael Long who did the same things that they did to each other for me with some of his tap outs, and I wasn't even ready for some of the hits he was going to do for me. But what I'll say about Long is the most unselfish footballer I ever played the game with. He wanted your success more than you did, and this was a moment for me, not for my kick here or the 100th goal, but Longy wanted me to kick the 100 more than I did. So he gave me some of the easiest goals through the 90s, because he didn't want to kick him. He wanted me to enjoy this moment. So I said, one of the most caring people, and you've seen what he's done for his people, but as a teammate, just one of the most loyal people I've ever met in my time.
Most wonderful, humble, giving person.
And very funny, humorous.
That's hilarious,
And it's not without controversy, but the Indigenous round is going to unfold this weekend, including back-to-back games in Darwin, which is wonderful, including the Dreamtime game. So that was this week's final five. We'll get tougher. We'll toughen up again next weekend.